What's up guys, Ivan Carranza here, and today we're gonna take a look at my new Evolution Wireless Digital Unit by Sennheiser. Now, this is not a sponsored video in any way. I have, at the moment, as of the filming of this video, no affiliation with Sennheiser. I paid full price for this, and why I decided to buy this was mainly because I've been using the wireless for in-ears by Sennheiser for the past half a year with great results, and I've been meaning to get a unit for my bass, so that's why I decided to buy it. I'm excited about it. Let's unbox it and see and test how it works. Also, what we're gonna do, unlike many YouTube reviews of wireless units that they review in their studio and then maybe walk around a little bit, you know, go out to the yard and come back to test the distance, I'm gonna take this to the real world. I'm gonna use it on stage because I have a couple of gigs coming up this month, actually quite a few of them. So I'm gonna be using this in the real world and testing it live to see how it performs, and then I'm gonna report back and let you know. But first, let's unbox it, show you how it works, and then we're gonna see the world, or the real world report. Let's check that out. Well, open it up. Flip it the other way. Now, here we can see this is the receiver. You have the body pack or strap pack or belt pack. You have some batteries that it comes with. The instrument cable that you screw in. This goes to your instrument. I'm probably gonna need to buy a replacement of this just in case. And something that I like is, pull this out, just break it. This is pretty cool. No more plastic by Sennheiser. Everything in the box is eco-friendly paper, which is really appreciated. Great work, Sennheiser. I really like it. And here we go. You have some buttons here in the front, your screen. In the back, you have an XLR out, also a quarter inch out, which is balanced or unbalanced. Two antenna and the socket for the power supply. Also, you get this little tray. I think it's to mount two units into one. Get your two Sennheiser antenna. And here we have adapters for the power supply. This is the power supply. And this is the rack mounting kit, just like in the in-ear wireless unit. Now, what's interesting here is that compared to the body packs of the wireless for in-ears, where you have a screen, you don't have anything here because you control everything from the app by Sennheiser. So let's check that out. I'm gonna plug it. The unit, and then we're gonna see how this performs. So I went to my bathroom and back, and no issues so far. So I think it's a good sign. I'm gonna run maybe a set list today with it to test the battery. And then I'm gonna use it live to demonstrate how it works and so on.
What's up, guys? Iban here, and I'm just back from a gigging weekend where I used the Sennheiser Evolution Wireless Digital for the first time. I played a couple of shows, one at a small festival, and the other one was just a full-on headliner show in a club, and it worked extremely well. I'm really happy with the performance, and also, very importantly, with the battery life, because I was a bit scared that my belt pack would die mid-show, but the battery performed fairly well. One thing that I noticed is that for some reason, the first 25% of a full battery charge, and I'm using some rechargeable lithium batteries, for some reason, those 25%, the first, you know, from 100 to a 75% drop fairly quickly, but then throughout the entire set, then it decreased progressively slower, so that by the end of a two-hour show, I had still about 50 to 55% battery left. Now, I had some spare batteries, of course, but I got a bit scared the first, you know, two times, because I saw my battery draining like fairly quickly after a couple of songs only, and I was like, oh, how is this supposed to last for an entire set? But then it worked fine, so I'm really happy with that. Now, you can adjust all the parameters on the receiver itself. You have some arrows and a menu that you can adjust, but it's a lot easier to use the mobile app for that. So if we go here, you can see that I open up the menu and I'm in a profile right now. It says my name, of course. It's green because it's working. And if my transmitter was off, let me turn it off. You can see now it's red. So you can really say or tell that the transmitter are not working if something's wrong with it. So let me turn it on again. Now you can see it's green again. Now here you can see the battery percentage, and you know it's more than what I said. It was close to 60%. Actually, it was 65 before I started recording, so plenty of battery. So now if I tap onto my name, I see some more options. You can see that there's the name of the transmitter, the EWSK, the battery percentage, the frequency, and below you have the settings, and you have the audio link controls. You can key lock the receiver. You can mute lock the transmitter because there is a mute switch there. And if you want it to stop working to avoid surprises mid-show and not knowing why you're not having any signal, you can mute or you can lock that function so that this switch doesn't do anything. Now you also have the ability to adjust the gain coming out of the transmitter from -3 to +42, and I noticed that from my basis, +39 is the, you know, ballpark of, or it's compared to when you plug in directly with a cable. Then you can adjust the output of the receiver. On the back, you have an XLR out, or also you can use an unbalanced or balanced cable. And I noticed that in reality, to match the output of the bases, +5 is the right number, but we don't have that option, so I go with +6. You can also change the frequency manually. You can see right now we are 824 and 200 megahertz. I'm gonna move it to 830 and 200 megahertz and do okay. And right now you can see sync transmitter. So I have to sync this to the phone and to the receiver, and for that I just tap on sync transmitter and press the sync button here once, and we're good to go. Easy as that. Also, you can do an auto scan to find frequencies automatically. That really helpful if you just want to, you know, make your life easier. However, in some locations, especially festivals, they give you certain frequencies that you have to use. So that's when you use the manual setting of frequencies. And then you have some advanced frequencies like device information. You can forget the device of your phone, so if you want to sync the transmitter to something else, you can do that as well. But overall, you know, it's fairly easy to use the whole system, the transmitter, the app, and the receiver. And like I said, the wireless worked really, really well. I'm really happy with the decision to buy it, and I'm going to keep carrying it on my Peli case because I don't know when I'm going to get a rack to build it in, you know, inside. And right now I can carry my entire rig with that small suitcase, that Peli case. So I really like my decision to buy this. Now, I'm sure a lot of you are going to ask, why didn't you buy one of those pedal board or small wireless units? The reason why I did not do that is because those operate at the 2.4 or now some of the 5 point something gigahertz range. And those, at least here in Germany, are very prone to dropouts, especially when you're playing larger shows and open airs, festivals and so on. And a lot of people that have had dropout issues because those are, you know, the frequencies they operate in are crowded by mobile phones, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, and so on. So with this, you're not operating that range, so you're ensuring that you're going to have a more stable signal. I hope you guys liked the video. Let me know what you think in the comments. And also, don't forget to subscribe, hit the notification bell to stay up to date with the content that's coming to the channel. As always, thank you guys for watching. Let me know what you think in the comments, and I'll catch you guys on the next one. Take care. Mm-hmm.